Good evening everybody. In this video, I am going to show you how to fill the student details to upload in G Suite. I believe you have already downloaded the CSV file from our KV Hebbal WhatsApp group. I have also downloaded that file and I have filled that file and I have uploaded also. So once you downloaded that file, change the file according to your class and section. I am the class teacher of class 8th and section B. So here you can see I have changed or renamed the file 8B. So open the file and here I have already filled the information fields and I have uploaded this file successfully into G Suite. So let me tell you what are the fields which are compulsory or required and how to fill those fields. First one is first name required. So whichever is required, I am going to highlight that in yellow color. So you have to fill the student name under first name. Only the student name has to be filled without leaving any space and without initial. So first name must be only the student name without any initial and without any space, and this is compulsory. Now come to last name. This is also required. So under last name, as per the instructions we received, you have to fill the class and section in small letter and 2020. If you are the class teacher of 8A, then the last name will be 8A2020. If you are the class teacher of first class section A, then the last name will be 1A2020. In the same way, if you are the class teacher of 12th class, then the last name will be 12A2020. So in this method you have to fill this last name, and this last name will remain common for all the students of your section. And now next one is email address required. This is also compulsory, and in this email address you have to enter in this way. You have to begin the email address with small s, and then 1046 is our school code. 1046 is our school code, and then you have to take the name, first name of the student Yashoda Nanda, and then you have to enter the admission number of this student, and at elearnkvsroblr.in. Now there are 2-3 methods are there to create this email address. First method is manual typing. You have to type this email address manually using the school code and the student admission number. And the second method is you can have a formula. The formula also I am going to show you, but if you use that formula, when I share this file with you, that formula won't be available for you because this CSV test file will not contain any kind of formulas. So I am going to share the formula separate, and what you have to do is you can use that formula here and you can generate the email address properly without any problem. Next one is password. This is required field. So and here the password is common password you can keep for entire class. As I am the class teacher of 8B, the password I have created is KVH all small letters 8B@121. This password will remain common for all the students of your section. So once you drag this, it will come to all the students. So last name and password will remain common for the entire class, and this field is not required. And come to this field, organization unit path, it is required. So let me highlight it. And now what is this organization path? When I share this form with you, this will be available to you all. As I am a class teacher, I have to create this organization path slash KV Hebbal, Bengaluru slash students slash 8 space B. If you are the class teacher of 1A, then at the last you have to write 1, give space and write A. And this will also remain common for all the students. You need not to create separate again. So this will remain common for all of your class students. And next one is recovery email. So you have to select the student's email ID here, because if you give recovery email ID, in future if they face any kind of problem, they'll get the password or link to their email ID. And as well as you have to even provide recovery phone number. So if you provide recovery phone number, when there is a problem, the students can change their password by getting or receiving OTP into their mobile number. But the mobile number entry is little difficult or little confusing, so let me explain. So here, if you select this field, the mobile number is beginning with 91, but in front of that you have to add plus. That means you have to enter the mobile number starting with plus 91, and then the 10 digit mobile number you have to enter. But sometimes what happens after you entered, and if you come to the next field, it won't in that same format. So to avoid that problem, so you have to first enter inverted comma, I mean single inverted comma in front of the entire number, or you can begin with single inverted comma, then press plus and then write 91 and then write the entire mobile number. So I'm going to show you how to do that once again. So here first I'll enter single inverted comma, then 91 and then mobile number 9440704917, and come to the next. So if you select and if you enter the number in this way, see again there is a problem, it is not accepting. So again you have to enter the plus. If this mobile number is not in correct format, then while uploading this form, won't Google Suite won't accept this to upload. So you have to enter this clearly and carefully. This is the way you have to enter the recovery mobile number, so that students can change in case any problem comes in future. Next here, school code. Actually this is different in original file. I have made this to make you to understand. So school code also remains common and same for everybody. In the admission file, I mean in the user file which you have received, this will be in a different name, but I am going to give you this 1046 only, because that is our school code. Once you drag it, the school code will remain same. And Q is admission number, and you have to enter the admission number of each and every student. And then remaining fields are not mandatory. Only one field is important, this one, change password at next sign in. So you have to make this column true, so that students can change their password once they log into the Google Suite. So two things I have changed in this file, school code and admission number. But in original file, this school code is having a different nomenclature and admission number is having a different nomenclature. To make you to understand, I have written this school code. So I'm going to change that to exactly what actually is given in the user file. And these things you have to fill so that we can upload the information properly in the G Suite. Now if you want to fill other fields, if you have information ready with you, you can also fill the password which you have already generated, already you have created to the students. But if you have password created by you or created by students, if you have a ready password, then what you have to do is you have to make this true into false. That means if you make this true into false, the students can't change their password after they log in. But it is better to keep this as true even though you have created a password, because in future if they have any problem to change their password, they can easily change the password. Now this is the way you have to fill the form or user form, CSV form, which was given to you. Now coming back to this email address, the formula is already with us. Kiran ma'am has provided the formula, so I can show you how to use that also. Copy this formula and paste here under email address, and this is the formula which will auto create the email address for all the students once we enter their admission number and school code. So let me show you how it actually works. Now let me drag this, and then I will add new file. Let me type Swami. See, you can see here Swami name has came here, and school code remains same. Now I have to change the employee code. That means the admission number 23058 I will write. Okay, I have typed 23058, and now let us see whether it has become, yes, it has changed. So the email address is also auto generated. So once you paste the formula here, and once you generate all the formulas, then finally you can copy this again, and then again paste it as a formula, so that there will be no confusion while we upload the information in the Google suit. So this is the way you have to complete filling form details or information in the user CSV file provided to you. Now those teachers who have information regarding the school building name, all those things, of course if you have information ready with you, the student's address and all those things, parent mobile number, parent email number, of course you can provide. We will definitely upload those information also in Google suit. But these information or these fields which are highlighted with yellow color are must. Now so thanks for watching this video, and if you have any doubts, you can send a message to me in WhatsApp. I'm ready to rectify, or I am ready to help you all. Thank you very much for watching this video. Bye bye. Take care.